We had a new release today. Football is quite underway, and it's quite the hot topic amongst the hobby right now while these rookies are performing. And we had a new release today, which is 2020 Illusions. And if you've been breaking or been watching Illusions over the past couple years, it's pretty much the same format. What I like about it most is for a group break format, you got five hits. So you do an inner case of eight boxes, you get 40 hits. So a lot more base than too. Yeah, a lot of base, a lot of base parallels. I know you haven't broken any yet, C-Rab, but what are you looking forward to with Illusions football?
In general, you know, like Illusions start off real funny. As we know, that's been breaking it for a few. It started off, they used to give you an encased base card.
Yes.
Which
back in the day.
Just the idea of like giving you an encased base card is very strange. With its own packaging.
But that may work now.
True.
Yeah.
It would probably work better now than it did
when it first came out. Yeah. So,
because if you got some Joe Burrow like encased uncirculated base card that's short printed. Mm-hmm. Could go for a lot.
Yeah, but then you go to the next step, and then when people like crack them out and like grade them, they're like, this hasn't even been touched by anybody. Why is this not a gem mint 10?
Right.
Get into that whole issue. But in general, yeah, like it's a good product with a lot of hits. You do get, and the good thing is like you get the base of both worlds, like we were just saying. You get your hits, and then you do get a lot of base cards from the boxes as well. So once they switched that format to where the encased card was actually a hit, I started enjoying the product a lot more. I guess what we were just talking about, even if we went back and the encased card is a base card, I don't know how much I would necessarily enjoy that from this particular product. Now, if they did something like that for Prism,
right,
that might be a different story. But for this product, I like that the encased hit in its own separate bag is a hit. Not just a base card.
Well, if you also remember, they used to pair up, every base card used to be paired up with another legend from the team. Well, no, it was the same team, but it would be like, it was some awful pairings. It'd be like, I don't know, like I can't even think of like how bad some of them were, but it'd be like an old Jets quarterback with a current Jets quarterback. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. It'd be like, I mean, Steve Young and like Cody Pickett or something. You know, it was like two pairings and it didn't work. Now what they've done with that is they've made that a case hit, which I don't think we even hit. If you go to one of the images we have here, you could see the Tua Dan Marino, right? So that's
dope.
A case hit now, whether it's before, I think it was the first year it came out, that was like a base card.
Yep.
So now those are super rare to hit, and I don't even think we got one.
I did.
You did? Okay.
I did, but the mock photo you're showing, it's not numbered. The one I pulled was like numbered to 12.
And was it the Edelman one or?
It was Edelman.
Edelman.
It was Randy Moss and Julian Edelman.
Oh, okay.
And it was like numbered to 12, and it had like a weird film on it that I've not seen Panini use before.
I'm from these pictures, because I haven't seen this year's version yet. From these pictures, are they playing with more colors this year in the product?
Because
look at that Joe Burrow. That's like almost like a color.
Yeah,
burst.
They on those RPAs. Yeah, they have the kind of the color blending in the background. It's still. I mean, the mock actually makes it look more colorful. I think it looks similar to last year, in my opinion.
Okay.
But you're getting a lot of numbered cards. I think you're getting like at least five numbered cards along with your hits per box too. So it's a pretty good value, and I like the encase because I think as you break it, you're leaving that for the end, right? And it's like, oh, what do we got? And it's pretty cool. So it'll be interesting to see how collectors take it and see where it finds its place. Because it's kind of like that in-between product, right? It's not chrome.
It's a product that I feel that completely gets looked over. At the end of the year, when we go back and we see every release that was in the category for that specific year, we don't ever talk about Illusions. It's kind of in the maybe like certified. I think Phoenix has taken a significant step up. I know we talked about it before, but you look at the secondary market on Phoenix, it's going through the roof.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But I think Illusions is kind of like that certified, maybe a cheaper version of encased. You still get the encased card, but it's not graded.
Mm-hmm.
But you also get a lot more base parallels and base cards in this. So it might be considered like an encased, but a budget version of encased.
Yep. Yeah, that's a good comparison. Yeah, and I'm actually surprised on how Phoenix is taken off this year, like you mentioned. There's actually a few people in the chat that said that they were in Illusions, but they're like, oh, you know, I want to see more Phoenix. So, you know, they want to see more Phoenix as well.
We tore the end and run on them Phoenix,
yeah.
Boy.
Yeah, we got through it. So, yeah, so some pretty cool stuff. They got a lot of inserts, so we'll see how some of the Brady, some of the Mahomes stuff goes. I think the acetates are kind of confusing because the numbering's on the back. You can't really tell, you know, right away, so you got to flip those things around, and sometimes the colors don't bleed right. Yeah, we're excited. We got more illusions today. We're going to have it more throughout the week as well. We probably will have some for personals as well next week. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, one of the better values in the hobby, and kind of the little preview for Prism No Huddle is releasing next week.
Very strange.
So Prism No Huddle is, I don't believe there's many silvers in the product, but they do have those disco, I think they're calling them, parallels, one auto. So I don't know why Panini's releasing the No Huddle version of 2020 Prism. And then 2 weeks later is when the hobby comes out. So.
Yeah, that's very strange to me. It's going to be strange to do a different SKU than the main one first. That rarely ever happens. If anything, they come out on the same day.
Mm-hmm.
But having a different SKU, not the regular hobby coming out first, that's strange.
Well, right now it's a weird week next week for football releases because, like you're saying, you do have No Huddle Prism, but you also have Panini Rookies and Stars.
Oh yeah,
which
that
is also
weird.
Releasing. And am I looking at Immaculate Basketball as well?
Yes, yes, mm-hmm. That's gonna be a big release.
So big Panini release.
Maybe they didn't want to do Immaculate Basketball and Prism Football on the same. I don't
know.
Yeah,
but they're doing like two football products that. I mean, I know Prism has gone way up,
mm-hmm.
but it's kind of the same price point.
Yeah, it is.
The secondary market is like driven Prism up through Prism through the roof, but originally back in the day, Rookies and Stars and Prism were in the same price point.
Well, here's what I'm thinking. There's a couple reasons on why this happened with Prism. I think could be that they didn't finish all of it, but they finished the No Huddle first. So that could be the reason.
Because there's going to be way less cases of No Huddle.
There's going to be a lot less cases. Or if you think about it this way, from a business, from a monetary standpoint, you give people a little taste of it, and then that's going to drive up the price on the hobby cases, which they have
Right? Could we drive it up any more than it is right now?
Yeah, and then Panini is not necessarily going to be the one that's reaping all of that secondary market price either. You know what I'm saying?
Well, you know they're going to come out with some on their website, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then they also are probably, I'm assuming they're going to come out with first off the line Prism Football. So,
oh, they're absolutely going to.
So they're going to already have the No Huddle that people are seeing, and then they're going to post that first off the line Dutch probably, right?
And then there's one more SKU, right, of Prism Football this year that they have.
Is there a choice maybe? There's probably a lot of SKUs, but yeah. The hobby versions. But one thing to keep in mind with the huddle is it's going to have, like basketball, it's going to have one variation rookie per box. Mm. So just like the fast break Prism for basketball. So that, you know, you get a Joe Burrow to one of those, it should be a pretty valuable card. You know, it should be pretty sought after.